we are live.
Yes, this is Raju Srinivasan reporting from Cyrus Brocha's office, actually his father's office. Father's retired sort of, and so now it's his office. Anyway, Raju's got a lot to say. Beginning, before I call Vishal on, who's of course a multi-billionaire and is going to help me buy better clothes that fit me properly. People ask, yesterday did a show which went on for 12, 14 hours, and people ask, how do you manage? How do you keep your energy up and this and that? So I can't lie anymore. Just like Boost is the secret of many people's success, GasX is the secret of my success. GasX, please take it twice a day with food. All right. And if you're really pumped with things, take it thrice a day. All right. Let's go and meet the one and only Vishal Gondal, who is very famous for many different things. I'll have to give a small introduction. Firstly, he's with the IBM family. So this is incest again. We are having sex with ourselves. We should never do this. India, please be warned. Even if you're a dwindling tribe, do not, conjugate amongst yourselves. Is conjugate the right word? I have an English dictionary right here. I'll come back with it in a minute. Vishal started his entrepreneurial journey. At this point, Rishi and company, who are our backstage boys, you're supposed to put relevant music. Please don't wait for me. Vishal started his entrepreneurial journey at the age of 16. Oh, 1 se 15 kya hua pata nahi. Nobody's giving us that whole period, the missing life of Vishal Gondal, which is what I will ask. No one has asked you this, Vishal. I will ask you. By the way, why don't you talk? I'll just keep on like this. How are you doing?
Very good. Fantastic.
Hussein. Hussein and hand. Hussein painting behind, and I saw a hand on the side.
Just that's my Ferrari room, by the way.
Wow. You park your Ferrari in your own house. Itna paisa hai aadmi ke paas, yaar. Unbelievable.
Nahi, nahi. Maine Ferrari ka room bana diya. Ferrari gaadi le nahi sakte.
What are you saying, Baba? That's like having a blonde girlfriend without the girlfriend. What's the point?
Because I need to buy a road. Ferrari khareedna aasan hai, but jab tak main 10 km road khareed nahi sakta, main Ferrari nahi khareed.
Aur Ferrari ka 50% paisa aap rakh lo side pe, because you'll need it for parking. Remember that. This is going up every minute. Okay, Vishal, before we make fun, you founded India Games and you're best known as father of the Indian gaming industry. What kind of language is this, father of the Indian gaming industry, sir? शर्म नहीं आती है कौन लिखता है मैं चुदगिरी फादर यंग गाय लाइक योरसेल्फ द वर्ड फादर शुड नॉट कम फॉर द नेक्स्ट 15 20 इयर्स इट्स अ लॉट ऑफ रिस्पांसिबिलिटी बट जोक्स अबाउट ऑब्वियसली यू मेड सच बिग इनरोड्स फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग लेट्स गो बैक टू 16 फर्स्ट बिफोर वी लुक एट द रेस्ट ऑफ द बायोडाटा कैसा हुआ कब हुआ हाउ एट 16 हाउ डिड दिस जस्ट गिव अस अ लिटिल बैकग्राउंड
सो इन स्कूल आई यूज्ड टू ओनली डू टू थिंग्स मेक गेम्स एंड प्ले गेम्स I had a computer very early in my life. My dad had bought me something called the Sinclair ZX Spectrum. And I used to make programs and games on it. And then my other job was I used to play volleyball. I was a national volleyball player.
So you like big balls?
Big and small both. Because when I was playing volleyball...
Father. कौन सा एंगल से फादर है मैं जो तुम्ही से बात नहीं करता यार
नो आई मीन वॉलीबॉल वाज अ डिफरेंट गेम बट व्हेन आई वाज प्लेइंग और मेकिंग कंप्यूटर गेम्स वी डिड नॉट गेट दैट सेम साइज
विशाल विशाल योर नेम इटसेल्फ इज लार्ज यू डोंट नीड लार्ज बॉल्स हां ओके सो यू लाइक टू प्ले गेम्स एंड मेक गेम्स बट हाउ डिड यू नो दैट यू हैड ऑल दिस टैलेंट इन यू
एक्चुअली यू नो आई जस्ट मेड गेम्स एंड देन आई फिगर्ड आउट आई नीड समबडी टू पे फॉर दीस गेम्स because you know my father finally said kya kitna matlab you know get some life matlab you know ye kya hai that was the time actually there was a Pepsi office near my house in Devnar so I said that you know and Pepsi Coke war was at its peak
correct
so I decided to make a game where you could shoot at Coke bottles using Coke cans using Pepsi bottle and then I've entered the Pepsi office I was in shorts and t-shirts I actually took my entire computer there And I wanted to show them this game I have made. And they were like, ये क्या है? बच्चे को बिठा के रखा है?
They would, एक Pepsi पिला और पका.
Yeah. But then finally, the guys came for after 2 hours and saw this game and he got damn pumped up. And then, you know, I don't know if you remember, there was Vibha Paul, who was the...
Of course, Pepsi head.
Pepsi head. So she was there and then Vibha was visiting.
Yeah.
And then she saw the game. And you won't believe, they paid me 5 lakhs and bought that game and installed it on every Pepsi employee's machine so that whenever they were getting demotivated, they could shoot at Coke cans.
Are they paid me less just to endorse the product for 3 years. And then replaced me with Amitabh Bachchan, even older. Unbelievable. 5 lakhs, bro. What a story this is, yeah. This is a glorious story. It's like an opening with a debut for India, 100 on debut. So you just had this idea. What firstly we're talking about balls, and now it's almost like I'm a genius because the relevance of the balls. Or is it because you're just young that people are just so brave? I love this story.
See, I think
made my day.
It's possibly because I was not educated. I'm a college dropout. I never studied. So I never
once again, Kripaya, dhyan dijiye. Once again, the secret to success, dropping out of college. Another bloody millionaire who doesn't have a degree.
No, no, but I mean, I think, you know, it's been told to you that if you don't have an MBA, you cannot do marketing. If you don't do sales training, you cannot do sales. You know, you've been taught that you have to learn something and then you can do
Vishal,
something.
Vishal, statistics bhi ek cheez hai na. Obviously, the 98% of those MBA guys do get jobs and 98% of the guys who without degrees may not land up like Vishal Gondal.
The question is who hires those MBAs, right? So, I think the bottom line is that, yeah, you know.
Oof, last word with sir. Okay, excellent. I love this story. This is the best story I've heard of the week. I can't believe you as a young kid with balls of brass walked into the Pepsi office and what a hugely, when you think about it, genius idea. I mean, it's absolutely, for morale, there can't be anything better. And they are such cutthroat. I mean, if you want to describe corporate cutthroat, Pepsi and Coke would be the number one and example in the world.
They hated each other. I mean, it was not just like, you know, business rivalry was different. There was hate, literal hate between them.
Wow. Exciting beginnings. So then once you get a 5 lakh check back in the day, then what does Vishal do next?
Then I launch a gaming company. Called India Games, with the idea being that we are going to create Indian themed games. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I was all of 22 and I hire these two guys who come in full suits in my office and they say they are from this company called Price Waterhouse. I thought, you look, Pani water supply. I said, I don't need water supply. They said, no, we are a banker. So I said, I don't need a banker. I have a bank account. Huh. They said, no, we are an investment banker. I didn't get anything. They finally told me what we will do is we will get you money which you don't have to return back to anyone. I said, wow, that's a great thing. That they called it venture capital. So I'm talking of 1998, 99, the word venture capital.
This is where you had no idea that these guys wanted to invest.
Yeah. No, they were the bankers. They didn't want to invest.
They were finding investors, but...
Yeah. And I said, I don't want money. Because
so
I don't
only
want...
on this one Pepsi story, they heard of you basically.
Pepsi and a few other games.
But the Pepsi one being standing out, I'm just thinking how the corporate world would have picked it up so quickly.
No, because that story was covered in Brand Equity and Economic Times had done case study on it.
Brand Equity and Economic Times has to be given some credit then, because I think that also helped. The word got out that there's this guy. So it's almost like looking at talent scouts in cricket or baseball, where they actually go and keep their eye on the ball and see a guy in some small town and figure out that once again, this is the next Bill Gates.
The funny thing is that finally they told me that, you know, they will get me the money for what is called success fees. Success fees, mere baap ka kya jaate, tum paisa le aoge to de denge. And you won't believe, they created this thing called the business plan. And the best way to describe this business plan, I had never made a business plan. What they simply told me is ek Excel sheet hai, uske andar numbers hai. And if you click on one number, it opens another sheet. Now open another number, another sheet, and another number. Like, you just keep opening and it keep opening number of sheets. And the more sheets there are, the more excited investors get. And I was like, what the hell is this? And they created this business plan of this very complicated Excel. And we started meeting investors. And before I knew anything, 3.5 crores was committed to be invested in the company in a matter of weeks.
Boss, you're doing stand-up. Do you realize you're doing stand-up? It's hilarious what you're doing. You act like this bola guy who has one genius idea and he doesn't know why the world is now. You have to become like the new prophet. People want to follow you and throw paisa.
I did not know what capital meant. I did not know what stock or equity was. I did not know.
Are you serious?
How did I know, man? I was 21 years old.
I wanted you to swear on camera, Vishal Gondal. You had no idea about what equity is, what stocks are. You just made your game.
TY become fail. मतलब ये सब कैसे?
This is nothing to do with TY become, Baba. Huh? You don't really?
In 1998, how do you know all these things, yeah?
Because your friends or somebody's father's in the market, or I don't know. How do we know? I wasn't paying attention in college either.
So bottom line is that we got funding 3.5 crore. And the best thing was I did not even know what share percentages was. So two investors came. One said, I need 35%. The other said, I need 30%. And the balance came to me. So that's how the valuation of the company was also decided. Because I was like, yeah, somebody's going to give me 3.5 crore, which I don't have to return
but
back.
Who decided to cut the equity that way? Somebody else?
I mean,
the guy walks in and says, this is the deal.
Yeah, absolutely. And I didn't care, right? I mean, imagine you're 21 and somebody's giving you, you know, all this money with the only concept I had in mind, I don't have to give it back. That was my only concept.
I'm telling Silvery, who's listening to everything, our producer, we're writing down these points. We're making a little stand-up routine out of it when we get to do some corporate gigs. Because of who you are, it's funny. Otherwise, it's not funny. But the fact that you're super successful and that you act, I can't believe it. Honestly, I can't believe all this. I mean, I'm believing it, but it's just ridiculous. Because it can't be made up.
It can't be made up. Ki baat nahi. I mean, the point is, if you know too much, then you negotiate too much with people, right? I did not know anything. I said, yeah, great. Let's do the deal. And we could sign the deal. I'm glad we did that, because after that, soon in few months, the whole internet thing went bust. So we were literally among the last people who got funded.
Wow, what a story. So a lot of karma also. So, I mean, not to take away from you, whatever your talents are, which are fabulous, but also right place, right time, maybe to some extent with the boom bust happening just after. Then Walt Disney steps in. Is that the right sequence of events?
Then, you know, from 2000 to 2012, we built a large gaming company focused on mobile gaming. We developed multiple games. We did Bollywood gaming. In fact, every major Bollywood movie. Ronnie, by the way, came in as one of our early...
Achha, tere liye Ronnie hai, not Mr. Skuvala. You had no idea who he was. Again, we got to a sitcom. This is our office.
Ronnie,
No, I'm saying when he enters the first time, I am Ronnie. Okay.
Ronnie came in 2006-07. He invested in the company, and then we built India Games. And then 2012 is when...
Had you heard of Ronnie and UTV and all that before?
I mean, I just knew of Ronnie. I mean, everybody knew Ronnie in the media industry, as you know. So I think it was a good innings, and I think we sold the company. And Disney was, you know, great. They bought UTV and India Games, two companies they bought. Mm-hmm. And that was the end of my gaming journey, because after that, I had a 5-year non-compete with Disney, which means I could not do gaming.
So for 5 years, you could make, but you couldn't sell?
Huh. No, I just, after 2013, for 5 years, I had a non-compete. So I could not be in the business of gaming.
So what the hell did you do for 5 years?
I started integrating gaming into health, and that's how I started Goki. So my point was that while I can't do gaming, but I can go and fix healthcare, because that's screwed up, right? I mean, there are billions of dollars spent in medicine, doctors, hospitals, but people are still sick. Diabetes,
vaccine.
Yeah, exactly, right? So I think the problem of healthcare is it is not about information. Everybody knows they should not smoke or drink or eat fried food. What people lack is motivation. And that is all about gaming, right? We can make you addicted to playing Candy Crush or any of that. So my point was, what if I could use my gaming knowledge to make people addicted to exercising, eating salads and jogging and, you know, doing all the good things in life. And that's how I started thinking about Goki. And in 2014, we launched Goki with the whole idea of the first company where we actually gave you a wearable device. But the device was not the business. What we actually gave you was a fitness coach and a service. So what you paid for was this coaching service, which comes in. And
it's monitoring you all the time.
It's monitoring you, but you get advice from a coach. They tell you what to do. So that was the whole idea in 2014, sorry.
But what is the rate for that? Just for the common knowledge?
I think we started the plans. These are plans. Like, so our plans can range all the way from 2,000 to about 7,000 a year.
Wow, that's not too bad at all. So you went from basically what some parents or my generation and above would say is wasting your time gaming to actually providing the other end of the spectrum, how to heal society.
Yeah, I mean, and that's the best part, right? Because what I realized was when I was in school, I was a national volleyball player, fit and athletic. But when I was making games, you know, instead of playing volleyball, I became a volleyball myself. I was 108 kgs.
Wow.
Yeah,
I was more like, Gondal. More Vishal. What am I saying? Yeah,
exactly. And that's when I realized that, you know, this whole health thing is I joined gym, I went to diet program, I bought wearables, nothing worked. And that's when I realized that, listen, I have to fix this for myself. And when I started fixing for myself, I went from being a couch potato, and then I ran 14 half marathons, 3 ultra marathons. I even went to Everest Base Camp. So I've made my own journey from being a couch potato to now, you know.
And how much you weigh now, Vishal?
I'm about 84, 85. But I think more importantly, it's not about being 84, 85. My goal this year is to get 6 packs. I'm already at 4 packs. Yeah.
Can you show 4 packs? Ek pack to dikhao.
Main kuch aur dikhaunga aapko. My other goal was to do a headstand unassisted. and I can now do 2 minutes to 3 minutes without anything ahead.
Okay, so if we go to a break, we can try that because you'll have to move your camera.
Yeah, and then I can do a handstand, which is also one of my goals, but I still need wall support. But without wall support, so that's my other goal. So I'm trying to, so my whole idea in life is that you should do what people tell you you can't do.
Correct. So by 22, if you make more money than your entire five generations and you're super successful and everyone wants a piece of you, what happens is you start doing crazy things like, how do I do a headstand or a handstand in public? I'm trying to understand how the brain has gone from this one wacky genius side to...
Somebody told me you can't do it, right? So that's why I want to do it.
So if somebody tells you you can't have sex with a man, are you going to do it?
Of course
not. Not that there's anything wrong.
Of course not. I need to be motivated to do it, right? Let's put it the other way around.
Okay. So handstand and headstand, huh? For sure. Six pack, though, I'll give you a little more time to get it right. But yeah, but how tall are you? Like 6 foot?
No. I'm about 5'7".
5'7". So 84, 85 is still a little hefty?
No, that's because I'm muscle building, no, boss.
Okay, you're muscle building. Okay, boss, I'm not arguing. You have too much money and too much equity. I'm not arguing.
I'm just telling you that because it's muscle weight also, right? Because if you want to go into technicalities, I can go to into a lot of technicalities of health.
No. It's fine. Do you power lift also?
No.
No?
But you know what I do? I do something even more crazier. And I think you should do it too.
What is
I
that?
I think you did talk about it. I heard in one of your shows. So I have something called bulletproof coffee. That's my go-to drink.
Right.
So every morning...
The pre-workout as well.
Basically, I don't have breakfast. So I've replaced my breakfast with coffee with butter. And now I've been doing it for a few years. And I think that's really what, gives you the energy to do whatever you want.
I just promoted GasX from Himalaya. We are hoping for them to sponsor the show. We think it's a perfect mix and match. If you want to discuss that in detail. However, I want to talk about the pitch because you don't have enough time. You've got too many things to talk about. Let's try and get one or two more in. The pitch, you were a judge on it, which is The Apprentice, right?
It was not The Apprentice. It was more like Shark Tank. Think of it like Shark Tank.
Okay, sorry.
Issue.
Yeah. And how was that experience being the judge?
I mean, again, it was great, right? Because a lot of these kids came with ideas. And I think what they really wanted was genuine advice. Because a lot of times you go to investors and their thing is they will never say no. The worst investors are, they will never say no. They will say, ye problem hai, wo problem hai, kal aao. Nobody tells you. And I think one of my big challenge with all these investor types is, listen, don't waste time of entrepreneurs. If you don't want to do something, say no. If you want to do something, say yes. And if you want to give some
advice...
What
is wrong with us Indians? You're spot on. Why don't we say no? Straight away, no. So that kisi ka time bacha sakte also. Both ways, actually.
So that is part of what I was trying to do at the pitch.
But
right?
Were you rude?
I mean, I was not rude, but I used to say ki ye chalega, nahi chalega, and with a reason why. And actually, it's very interesting that the four finalists who were there on the show, each one of them today has companies which raised money and went out to do something bigger. So there was a company called Dineout who was in the finalist. There was a company called Vunic which was in the finalist. There was a company called Headout. And all three companies are doing very well even now. So I think the good thing to really see is when people come to these shows, what really happens in their careers.
But how do you know? I mean, obviously, you are the real thing. You made the money and all that to prove it. How do you know that something is going to work? I mean, then wouldn't everybody be a millionaire if they had that ability to just sort of know?
Well, I think something is going to work is when you know that you are not going to give up till you make it work. So I think that's really the question, right? I think that when you have a question of yourself giving up, of not making it work, then it won't work. So
two girls filed police complaints against me for the same philosophy. Two girls back in the day. Now, hopefully the records have been cleaned with the influence that I had in the 90s, which I don't have now, Vishal Gondal. But yeah, I think your point is well noted. Let's now come to the main point. Not the main point, but what's happening right now. 4G, is it? 5 million? Tell us a little bit about what's the game about for the few people who may not know.
So what happened was, again, this is going back memory lane for me. So 2013, when I stopped gaming because of my non-compete and I entered the field of health and fitness, and Goki, Touchwood, is doing really well. We are making big strides. Akshay Kumar is our brand ambassador.
Arey, Akshay bhai, I was with him yesterday in a show. He's lovely, lovely. Yeah. He's typical Indian, now we have to show off immediately. Ameriko bhi malum hai, good friend. Yeah, sorry.
I think with Goki, all the stuff was going great. But what happened in gaming in India was something very terrible happened in India. I don't know if you know it, but I am going to tell you that.
Please do.
The most terrible thing happened is that everybody thought in India gaming is Rummy, Teen Patti, and all these various fantasy type games. So in the last 5 years, 5 to 6 years, most investment in India, you'll be shocked to know, all the money has gone to make all these kinds of games.
Card Teen games.
Patti, Teen Patti. Basically,
Tash,
they call
basically.
It Tash. I mean, let's put it, I call it gambling, and but people like to call it real money.
That's games. Your point, yaar. Okay, that's your point. It's similar to the IPL fantasy leagues and all this controversy behind that. Okay, so,
bottom
okay, got it, got
is
it.
That huh. With an exception of one game, Ludo King, which again, a friend of mine made, can you believe that if you open the top 10 list of gaming in India, there is Ludo King, then there is PUBG, all these Chinese, Korean, Japanese games, American games, and then there is Teen Patti, Ludo, Teen Patti, Rummy.
So after Ludo King, what is the next local game which is the best, the highest?
Teen Patti.
What are you saying? The youngsters of today who are doing this? It's like an old-fashioned game, yeah, in my generation.
I mean, so clearly youngsters are not doing it, right?
Market has changed.
It is about really, I mean, just imagine who are the people who can invest 10,000 and make 1 lakh out of it, right? So the whole idea. So anyway, I mean, I don't want to go into that.
Today's gamer is not yesterday's gamer. It's the year before's gamer. Got it.
I think the bottom line is that to some extent, there was nobody who invested in creating IP. So think about Netflix, right? Initially, Netflix had Narcos and all these foreign shows, but today it is dominated by all the top shows from India, and what is happening and the content of Sacred Games, etc., is going really well. So gaming is the only industry which is billions of dollars worth, but there is no Indian IP in that. And that is my whole idea. So when I, again, you know, at that time we were talking about creating games. So I said, we are going to take three IPs, cricket, music, and action. And create games around it. So on cricket, we are working on a game title which should be on soon. And in 2019, I got back into gaming. I collaborated with a team from Bangalore called Encore Games. So here I am playing the role of an investor, advisor, and mentor. I am not actually running the company now. And we started working on the title. The second title we worked on was a music game on Bollywood music. And the third title was an action game. But again, we wanted it to be Indian. So we actually codenamed it Bharat Ke Veer. That was a code name. And the idea was that, see, it's quite clear that none of the Chinese gaming companies are ever going to have you kill Pakistan or, you know, India fight with any of these things, right? Because of, you know, why. So I said that it's crazy. Why are Indians playing games which, you know, the characters you don't relate to, the storylines you don't relate to. But, you know, people in millions are playing these games.
So these games, you design the game only for the India market.
Exactly. I mean, India is the biggest market. I mean, if you really see...
Because we have the most time to kill. We are the most people with time. And I think nobody spends more time with their phones than Indians. It's a proven fact now.
No, I think if you look at gaming, right? So think about a mobile phone. This is the best gaming device. There are 300 million smart devices.
Hello, Vishal.
Right now.
Uh-huh.
300 million smart devices. And the
growing,
best
and
use
growing.
Case. And the best use case for this, apart from chatting and social media, is gaming. And gaming actually is a much better form of entertainment because it is interactive. So you are not passive. Your mind is also active at the same time versus...
I would argue that Pornhub also gives you the option of interactive, but I get what you're saying again. Yeah.
Yeah, but touch I mean, that's go. Not gaming. That's video. That comes in a different category. Hey.
Tomato, tomato, potato, potato. Yeah, come on. Fair enough. Huh.
So I think my simple thing was ki hum log Indian hai, so why the hell are we playing all these games? So we will create Indian games, and we started working on it. And that's when, you know, the whole lockdown happened and our team were working, and then Galwan Valley happened. So we said, screw it. We are going to create a game on Galwan Valley, given what happened with our Indian soldiers. And as you know, in that whole thing, it was only hand-to-hand combat. There were no weapons used. Mm. So we started working on it. And that's when, you know, I was talking to Akshay sir about something else. And I told him that we are working on this game, and he got very excited. So he is the one who actually suggested the title Fauji. So he said, "Kya, ye sab naam maam chodo, I'll give you a title." He thought about it and came back with a name. And even though we initially called it Bharat Ke Veer, he finally called it Fauji. And that was the
Fauji is much more catchy. Yaar. Huh. I mean, has he got equity?
Well, Akshay Kumar sir is our mentor and advisor. I mean, he doesn't need equity.
No, sir, politician ke jaisa, diplomatic answer. Okay,
no,
fair
enough. No, it's not that. I mean, I think the bottom line is that he's not doing it for money, right? I mean, okay. He's among the richest men in the world, etc., right. etc. For him, it was passion of doing something for the military. And that's where we came up with the other idea that 20% of our revenue is going to get donated to Bharat Kevir, which is the foundation he's supporting. So I think that's how we started working on the game. And then May, June, we announced the game in September. And then we were originally slated to launch it in December. But then we said 26 Jan is a much better day to launch a game. And that's when we launched the game yesterday.
Wow. All right. We'll talk about it in detail after the break with Silvery, who's a gamer himself. And I think it will be more credible than me, since my games are all lower body practices, which are outlawed in most cultures. But are you going to do the headstand? Is it possible?
Why not?
Oh, can we see it? But how will you adjust the camera and where you'll go to the door behind?
Yeah, I can zoom it back.
Full body dikhana padega. So as we go to a break, folks, we're going to have a quick headstand and then he'll, sit down and settle down again. Vishal Gondal. Yeah. Can we see
headstand
it?
Unassisted.
So ab pesh karte hai. Headstand unassisted. Part of the gaming world, Vishal Gondal himself. One of his aims in life, after making 100 million US, was to simply do a headstand without anyone holding his legs. And he's, for safety's sake, put the shirt inside the pant. This is live, ladies and gentlemen. There's no way he could have thought it through. Wow, not bad. And thankfully, he is wearing underwear, so everything is fine. Vishal can procreate. Now he cannot procreate. I think this is it. All laws of procreation have been broken. Now this is elegance. Shamak Davar class that I attended made me do the same thing. Wow, man. Superb. Well done. We'll give you 2 seconds to get ready as we take a quick break and we'll come back with Silvery. Well done. Well done, Baba.
That's enough.
Yeah, that's enough. We take a break. Get your breath back. That was fabulous. Really good.
Meaning.
More impressive than the games. Games are great. You made lots of money, but ye to hai. Sahi hai. All right. Quick break and we'll be back.
Fantastic.
Okay. Silvery coming in.
Hey, hi guys. Hello.
Okay.
So hello, should we get straight to the AMAs or do you want to do one topic or something?
Let's just discuss the headstand for 1 minute, yaar.
Firstly, yes.
Yeah, come on, can't ignore it.
Yeah, what a great headstand, right. Yes.
So just discussing here as we went into break, that was a fabulous headstand. Silvery, can you know, people always ask, can you do a headstand? Can you do a headstand? And they don't realize how tough doing a headstand is.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Okay, so can you do it?
I cannot. Are you all going to ask me to try?
I can barely stand on my legs. Headstand is like really pushing it. But very impressive, Vishal. Not bad at all. I must say, you've got these little small challenges along with your other challenges to conquer the world of games and, as an entrepreneur, different companies buying and selling at the right time. But I like the inner. So it's like two different worlds. The inner challenges, which are just you fighting you to achieve something.
I mean, that's what it is, right? We want to upgrade our phone. You want to upgrade your laptop. You want to upgrade your car. But what do you do to upgrade yourself? So in my case, my whole goal is that what I could do in 2020, the version 2021 should be able to do more things better than what it is last year. So I keep upgrading myself.
This is a very decent philosophy. You're rebooting in a sense, upgrading, however you want to put it, because we forget. While we're trying to achieve things materialistically, you know, some people do, you just forget about yourself. And suddenly, the guy is so successful, but he looks like a big orange. You know, that's really sad.
The orange is over, by the way. Orange is gone.
Orange gaya? To ab kya hai?
Abhi to naya again, Biden.
Oh, achha, waisa hi. You put an American. Yeah, that's true. Gone. Well, we have our own orange if you want to take orange further. Here to stay. All right. So now Silvery's walked in. Vishal, I don't know if you've met him. He's also IBM. I think, I don't know if he works with you. He's a stand-up comedian and he's a gamer. So let's ask him. Brother, Silvery,
yes.
Are you going to play 4G?
Yes, for sure. Absolutely. Without a doubt.
And you rank the
game? And I'm not just saying that. I'm actually looking forward to playing it. I'll be downloading it today, tomorrow, one of these days. Yes.
There you go. So just doing this podcast has made you one more dollar. Just okay. Do we have any topics, big guy?
Yes. We have one which is kind of not relevant? Gaming related. No, yeah. Not gaming related, but kind of like computer stuff related, like internet stuff related. A Flash shutdown. So basically Adobe Flash just shut down its doors, right? They just shut down supporting Flash. And a Flash shutdown in China basically crippled their railroad network in one city called Dalian. That's the city's name. Please don't hate me if I mispronounce it. But so basically the entire system had to be shut down for an entire day because Adobe Flash crashed, like stopped working. so they couldn't go ahead with their railroads, and they could only get it back functioning once they got a pirated version of Adobe Flash working back.
Oops.
So that's a very, I thought Vishal would be find that quite interesting.
Would you like to give your professional insight, Sarji, Mr. Hetsanji, upar se niche, niche se upar version?
So I programmed a lot of games in Flash, actually. Flash was the original tool used to make games.
Exactly.
And Flash was also the original tool used for videos until one man killed it. And you know who that one man is?
Wait, Silvery, who's the one man?
Steve Jobs?
Exactly. So Steve Jobs said...
Oh, what a guess that was.
That's a mental headstand for me from my young Turk punching well.
Steve Jobs said that he's not going to support Adobe Flash on the iPhone. He said on his dead body, Adobe can work.
But the reason being?
Steve Jobs didn't give
aesthetics.
You know, basically... He just hated Flash. And of course, he had some reasons, but he said no to Flash. And actually, that's the turning point in one of the biggest turning points in history, because even YouTube used to play the videos in Flash Player, even YouTube videos originally. And that's when the whole format changed to MP4 and native video and HTML and all that. So actually, what just happened and what China is doing just shows how outdated they are. You know, Steve Jobs killed Flash years back. And I'm surprised that they were even using Flash now.
So one man can make a difference. That's what we are saying. Yeah. Ouch. Okay. All right. Steve Jobs did a bad job is what we're getting at.
He did a good job.
Good job. Perspective ki baat hai, huh? Look, please go on, Vishal. Don't let me interrupt. I have no knowledge. I'm just trying to be silly. We're trying to listen to you.
No. So that's what I said. So Flash is actually that decision of Steve Jobs changed the world of the internet, actually.
All right. Silvery, happy?
Like this video is possible because Steve Jobs killed Flash. Otherwise, we'll all be using some version of Flash to even do this chat.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we'll take a minute of silence. So thanks, Steve Jobs. Online, write down. We'll come back in a few seconds. No, we won't. We'll just carry on. They're now ready for the AMAs. Have we got stuff right up Vishal's sleeve, which includes, by the way, fitness and all things holistic in health?
Yeah, we have a little from everything. But first, I have one very interesting one from school, like school-related kind of. Question. This one comes in from Fakhruddin H. He has sent in some other questions before this as well. Hi again, Fakhruddin. He says, hi, Cyrus and everyone. Have you ever scored so low in your school or college that you felt it was an accomplishment? I scored 8 out of 100 in history and I feel it's an achievement. What about you guys?
I have a lovely story. I put in my book also, which is true. And Rajiv Khanna, my friend, will kill me for it. But I remember that valencies, I don't know if I've told this before, valencies in chemistry was a bit of a tough one. They hit us with it, you know, from like without any sort of, we just didn't pay attention. And then suddenly she gave a pop test and nobody, who could balance things if you haven't actually looked at that whole table? So literally, I remember the list was being called out. Those days, humiliation was in the 80s and 90s was in front of everyone. So it'll be like, Brocha, 9 on 50. Hadani, 8 on 50. Saraya, 7 on 50. And then Khanna, who was sitting next to us, Khanna, who won? So, one second, let me just not laugh. So, we all felt better. And then you know how you pretend to feel bad when you've done badly, but someone's done worse. It's the most beautiful feeling, actually. So, hum log sab andar se, Rajiv, what the fuck, yaar? No, cannot be one. Go and fight.
Yeah.
Go and fight with Mr. Punus and find out the real answer. No one can get only one. 7, 8, 9 to punch hum log. So, he went back to the teacher and he very shyly said, sir, look, one is very bad. Can you at least round it up to 2? So he said, you idiot, it was half, I rounded it up to 1.
So Cyrus, I'll tell you my story.
Please.
You know, I'm a pro at computers, right? I could code like anybody. So in my computer exam in TY BCom, I said, yaar, ye unfair hoga agar maine exam diya. So maine bola, main sabko thoda lead dunga, so I will start the paper late. So I said, I will go 45 minutes late to write the paper so that everybody gets a 45-minute lead. This is the final exam.
Wow.
And I reached the examination center 45 minutes late and they say, sorry, we cannot let you write the exam. I said, ye kya? Bolte, there is a cutoff of 30 minutes. If you would have come 30 minutes. So what happened is, in this thing of giving everybody else a lead in writing the exam, they didn't let me the exam. So I actually failed on paper in computers.
Or a subject you'd have aced in your sleep. So you had to do it again? What happened?
I didn't give the exam again, but bottom line is in my mark sheet, it shows failed in computers also.
Again, another story you've given us. Never try to be good and help others. It always comes back to bite you. A lot of interesting stories. All right. We have time for a couple more.
Yeah. The next one comes in from Muhammad Akib. He asks, do you think Indians will ever appreciate Indian games? For instance, Indian gamers are teenagers who think Indian products are not very competent. What would you think about
that? Okay, so one sec. Vishal has sort of pushed that into a sort of gray area with this whole teen patti, et cetera, et cetera. We're clearly looking at people with money, hence obviously not teenagers in many cases. So that's one. So let him answer this question because I think he's the only one who has this information.
I think you know, we have this skepticism of our own products, right? Look at vaccines. India provides 70 or 80% of the world vaccines, correct? You know, Serum Institute is world known. But we are all doubting that, you know, Indian vaccine chalega, nahi chalega, you know, everybody who is, and their dog is debating vaccine and stuff like that. So I think somewhere a product, when it is made by Google, we think of it differently. When it is made by an Indian company, Paytm, we will always think of it differently, even though possibly the engineers are better. So I think it is a mindset more than anybody else. And I can challenge you right now that the products made by Indians and India are equally good or equally bad than anybody else over here. So I think it's a mindset, and not just for gaming. This mindset spans across, you know, other categories, whether it is electronics, whether it is even clothes for that matter. So I think this is a problem.
Desi complex. Can I ask you a really ridiculously difficult and immodest question? Does Vishal Gondal think, that sounds in third person, do you think that your gaming ability is as good as anybody in the history of the world?
See, the way games work is now, it's not like movies that you make a movie, you release, and that's it. You know,
but that's probably success-based. I'm talking about the quality of the game. The success we leave as
so,
not
so
the
So that's
barometer.
What I'm saying, right? So the way gaming works is you release your version, then you get data, then you improve, and then you release version 2, version 3, version 4, version 5. So you improve every day.
Brother, that's how... this is what you should have given Shadi.com. If we did it this way, everybody's marriage will survive. So you keep, this is the philosophy we've been missing. I'm going to borrow this and I'll share the copyright.
So if you look at gaming, I think the only way to screw up in gaming is if you don't learn. And all I can tell you is that we have one of the best learners. Our team is really one of the best. If you look at the experience of people who are working on the game, we certainly have that.
So DC games are as good as any other games, honestly.
It is not DC games. I would say the teams, right? I mean, it's the team which matters, right? It's like saying all movies made in India are good. You know, there are some good movies and then there are some bad movies. It depends on the director.
But is your team purely Indian or now in this global mix? In any case, in technology, it's always a mix of people, especially with high profile.
And yeah, let's say the core team, the design team is all Indian, of course.
Just acting out some false feelings. Silvery, next one. Yeah.
Vishal, would you ever be, this is my question, would you ever be interested in making like a GTA style game for somewhere like Mumbai or something? Is that a possibility?
I mean, we need to find a nice storyline. So GTA is, you know, so think about the GTA concept, there's GTA LA, Miami. It's all based on, you know, the Italian drug mafia and, as you know, the stories of GTA, right? So clearly, you know, Mumbai and something like Sacred Games backdrop. If you look at what's happening with a lot of the web series. So I think especially the web series is a good way to think of how gaming can be developed. If not me, I mean, people listening to the show, here is your chance to stop having all your top talent making Rummy and and make this good idea into a
one man's crusade against the crappy Indian card games. Huh. Okay, fair enough. All right.
Imagine you have IIT engineers who have left everything and making teen patti algorithms.
You're getting a really fat check. There's a word for that in English. You just do what you're told. No? It's fair enough, I guess. It's called compromise.
India, I'll tell you a very interesting story, right?
Yeah.
In India, you go to a vegetable vendor and ask him, he'll say his dream is that his kid goes to IIT, IIM.
Right.
And today, if you go to every IIT and IIM, they all want to become vegetable vendors online.
Yep. Yeah. Bhaji.com. Coming soon.
Yeah, groceries, hyper local, milk delivery. you know,
I think I want to get into transport. I felt during lockdown, transport was a fabulous thing, as in transport of goods. It just because it was one area which people were demanding and trying to find things and get things, you know. So rustic Amazon, where you need us to go to places where which are difficult for other people to go. I mean, so
you could combine delivery with stand-up comedy. Think about that idea, right? Like imagine if the courier boy comes and then delivers you a 5-minute stand-up. I would pay for that. So delivery charges, up charge kar sakte.
The tip is already gone. Do you realize that? In most cases, I'm Chetan this side. I said, did you know two men walked into a bar and tap, 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 tap.
Arre, agar idea achha hai, I'm telling you seriously. Normally people don't pay for delivery charges, right?
Yeah.
You could actually say delivery charge you can charge and deliver a stand-up.
Vishal, they don't let the guy into my building. Yeah, Vishara, they put it in the lift and send it up. Vishara,
but I'm telling you, this idea is going to work. You should try it. Talk to Amazon and do a deal and you can say...
Silvery, he's made billions of dollars with great ideas and he screws me with one. And I'll actually take it and say, Vishal Gondal, they'll Google, oh, yeah, great idea. Next thing, some idiot investor puts money in and they'll come after me when we have 100 failed comedians delivering. And remember, no Hindu-Muslim jokes. Huh?
But I'm telling you, essay idea chalte, you know, the most stupid sounding ideas end up working, man.
Yeah.
Don't think of rational ideas.
Silvery, you're younger than me. I'm cynical, yaar. And Vishal is not interested in this market. So it's got to be you. What do you think?
Yeah,
you'll do it?
I'll do it. Tomorrow. I mean,
think about it. You've got 10 guys under you. You start doing deliveries and they give entertainment with it. So the person has to know that he's getting entertainment. Otherwise, he goes to normal Scootsy, Swiggy, Joby. So he's only calling you for delivery because he wants that 2 minutes of stand-up.
Yeah, cool.
You know anyone? Can you tell me one guy who'll call?
You have to sell it in 2 minutes. So I have to go to his house, do one joke and then get lost.
What if the guy looks at you, no response, says, or batao?
Yeah.
He goes on for 45 minutes and not laughing. Because he's lonely.
Yeah. Also, most deliveries are done early in the morning. So, you just first thing you've woken up and this is our show.
Uncle, kam se kam chaddi pehno. Aisa stand up nahi chahiye mujhe. Okay, degrading show. Let's go. Last question. What do we do?
This one comes in from Devash Sood. This is for both of you. He says, any tips you could share for a newbie wanting to start a podcast? And also, how much in advance do you book your guests? I guess the first part of the question.
Let's see Vishal's point of view.
I mean, the best thing about a podcast is that you are, you know, my concept of a podcast is you are actually a fly on the wall on a conversation of two friends or two interesting people, right? So, I mean, this is not scripted. We are just blabbering anything. We are saying anything. And this is not trying to please anyone. I think we are just having fun. And I think if you are true to your content, because a lot of podcasts then becomes like Akashwani hai. You know, you are not trying to do Akashwani here.
Yeah. Don't judge by this experience, yaar. Some are nice. There's some nice ones out there, huh?
Akashwani.
No, mera. We are Akashwani.
Okay.
We are Brocha Broadcasting. We are BBC. Huh. No, sorry. But listen, finish yours. They're listening to you. I'm interrupting with stupid points. Please continue.
Any tips for a newbie podcast?
So you're saying don't make it sound like a Sarkari program. I get that. And what else?
I think the other thing is you should talk about a topic you're passionate about, right? I think, and it could be anything. The best thing about podcasting is you could decide to make a podcast on orange color unicorns. And people may be interested in listening to that.
Because you love it.
Yeah.
And I agree with you totally. What we call Josh Junoon. Without that sense of, you know, that's why I've always noticed we're discussing sports, me and say a fellow sports lover, only the sports people stand around. The others, because it starts becoming an intellectual exercise in conversation on spot. And then the same thing with gaming. You know, when you're with the right people, the other people, they don't have enough credibility to be around you. So you'll actually get the audience. What you're saying makes a lot of sense. Who are actually only involved in that vision, in that area? Passion is the same. So sex podcast then, Silvery? Kabhi karega hum log? Sex podcast mustn't sound like the government. So
we'll do that also. Delivery, no? We'll just show up. Sex.
Oh, shit, you idiot. That's already been done. 10 million years they're doing that. Oh. You chud. You Punjabis, I tell you. That's not a new idea. Vishal, kuch pata unko, yaar. Unbelievable. He's come up with prostitution after all this. You know, I'll provide sex. You chud. Everyone does that. Every bloody culture.
Well, I don't endorse this.
Yeah. Business model. This is not gaming. This game is off, not on. All right. Listen, this has been wonderful, Vishal. Yeah. Thanks for chatting with us. And we'll go to you for all expertise whenever you're available on the gaming front and more. because of course with the H10 there's much more to you than just technical genius. All right. Absolutely. Have a good
day,
sir.
Thanks a lot. It was great talking to you guys in the morning, and we hope that we'll continue this conversation later.
अभी क्या होगा लास्ट हेडस्टैंड हैंडस्टैंड
नहीं अभी कुछ
अच्छा ठीक है
इतने पैसे में इतना ही मिलेगा
दो मिनट स्टैंड अप करना पड़ेगा डिलीवरी के साथ